all it is. There's no magic wand, no secret weapon. I mean, you just work on it every day. I mean, that's the only way it happens.
I don't think I've heard you utter NCAA tournament this year. How important is postseason?
I just, you know, like, we just focus on the day. No, we just focus on the day. We really do. I mean, right now we're focused on how we get ready for Ole Miss. And I had the number one team in the country, and I wasn't talking about the NCAA tournament back at Indiana. I mean, it's what you do is you focus. We're late January here. We focus on our team and what we've got to do and be absolutely wrapped up in that.
I know, Ray, after the Mississippi State game, you were a little disappointed. But I saw you ran over to him, gave him a high five at one point during the Kentucky game. Were you happier with the kind of
Ray's capable, right? Yeah. Ray's capable. I mean, when you've got leadership on your team, you've got to be able to challenge them. And that's part of it. That's part of being a leader, right, is being able to be challenged and take that challenge. And then so many guys come in, and a challenge seems like a criticism or an all-out assault. It's not, right? It's to get them better. And Ray's been through it, and we expect a lot out of Ray. Ray expects a lot out of Ray. And you got to have somebody that's continuing to drive that and keep that honest when it's not where it needs to be. And I want Ray to be ultra successful long after he leaves Georgia. I promise you, I want him to be very successful. And as with all of them, and I mean, in a case in point with Ray. So that just becomes part of it. I love Ray. And just because a guy gets challenged or you're unhappy with him, that means you love him even more, right? Because what you're trying to do is make sure that they're getting the most out of what they have, even when they think they are or when they don't think they have more to give, right? You keep trying to get more, and that's the bottom line.
Given the difficulty of this league, and especially your team's first five games against Kentucky and Auburn, you know, setting the likes of that, how do you assess the play so far, and how do you see where your team ranks, you know, stacks up against the
rest? I don't. I assess it day by day. I mean, there's things that we've got to do to be better every day. I mean, there's no question it's the rebounding, and to answer your question specifically, I'd say the rebounding has got to continue to improve. Our ability to guard the dribble has got to be able to continue to improve. Our transition defense, we've got to run better. You know, we've got to run better. We've got to continue to make sure that we're moving the ball at a high rate. And then just be confident that shots are going to knock down. You know, we have not shot the ball great, all right? And Tennessee, we shot it pretty well. Memphis, we shot it pretty well, but we have not shot it great. We'll shoot it. We just got to continue to work on it. We spend a lot of time at that. And the most important thing you can have for a team is to understand that level of confidence they have to have when they do shoot the ball.
With a team as young as this, does the comfort factor of playing in your own gym maybe play more of a factor than it would with an older team and how a team plays at home?
I think it always does. I think it always does, no matter what age of your team. I think there's always that level of comfort, familiarity, your home fans, I mean, those type of things. And sometimes with young teams or with older teams, it can provide a distraction, right? Where the road sometimes doesn't bring that distraction. It brings a whole other level of distraction because you're dealing with the opponent. But I think the bottom line for us is we're learning about mental toughness every day. Right? And it's like the question, how do you cultivate it? You cultivate it every day. You know, whatever situation comes up organically, whatever situation you can create, however you plan practice, you know, the competition level, whatever you're trying to do, your competition level in practice, you're trying to create that so that they understand, home or on the road, that's how you win.
How has Anthony's development so far this year kind of compared to your expectations of him and players you've coached in the past?
Well, I haven't coached guys that have that talent level at that age, right? I've coached guys that have a lot of talent, but they didn't necessarily have it at the age that he has it at 18. So I didn't come in with expectations. I came in with knowing that we were going to have to develop him every day, work with him every day, help him grow every day. I'd have to go through things to get there and just keep building his game. And until you get around somebody, you can recruit him for 4 years or 4 days. I mean, it doesn't make any difference. It's all different until you get them, or it's all different when you get them, and how they process, how they learn, what they got to get better at, how they apply it, you know, how you build confidence, you know, how you tweak them, how you challenge them, you know, all those things are all part of the daily process. So we're just right in the midst of that, and I'm enjoying it.
Maybe two more questions.
How much do you guys practice in the practice gym as opposed to on the arena floor?
In the practice gym more when we're going to go on the road. Some of it's schedule-based, based on who has the gym. But I don't mind when we're in there, when we're going on the road. But, like, we're in Stegman yesterday, we're in Stegman today. You know, those type of things. As we're getting closer to home games, I want to be in that gym. If I have a choice, we're going to be in that gym in Stegman all the time, right, because that's where we play. But at the same time, because of the six baskets and things like that we have inside of the practice facility, that serves a purpose too. But we're going to be in Stegman as much as we can.
Anthony's a guy with a big personality. Do you see a different side of him at home, you know, when he can play up to the crowd and whatnot?
No, I never really think about it. I just wanted to play with enthusiasm and play with energy. I thought he did a great job the other night for getting off to a slow start, shooting the ball, to come back the way they did in that Kentucky game. He never lost focus. Yeah, I'm more interested in that than any of the rest of it.